Media personality Somizi Mhlongo-Motaung has been accused of intellectual property theft for his hit show Dinner at Somizi's. Producer Hastings Moyeng says he pitched a similar television show, an email thread shared by radio personality Eusebius Makaiza on social media suggests that the synopsis was sent to Mhlongo-Motaung in 2014 and then sent to the current producer in 2016. Moyeng says he did not receive a response from the producers. Somizi has since taken to social media to reject the claim made by Moyeng. He joins us now on the line. A very good morning to you, Somizi. Thank you for your time and thank you for joining us on Weekend Dawn. It's actually always a pleasure chatting to you. My first question obviously is, have you had any communication with Hastings Moyeng ever since all these allegations surfaced this week?
But you don't even give me a chance to greet you. Like, you just went straight to it. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for asking. And thank you for checking how I'm doing.
You're welcome. You're welcome. I could listen to you every day. You've got a beautiful voice. So your question was, have I...
So my question obviously is, have you had any contact with Hastings Moyeng? I do believe when you came out and had a live Instagram live session, you mentioned that had he come to you and spoken to you before, instead of going to social media or going to a lawyer, it would have been a better exchange between the two of you.
Do you mean, okay, I'm trying to understand your question. If you say, have I ever had a conversation with him before or during this time?
During this time, have you ever had any engagement with him?
No, I haven't.
So what's the plan now going forward? Are you prepared to go to court? Because it seems as though the court is the only place you guys are going to communicate now.
Absolutely. I think it's not a court battle between me and him. I think it's Chanel and his team or something like that. Because I think he sent the email to the Chanel. He's never communicated with me. I think my name is just being out there because I am the host of the show. So he is dealing with the channel, and channel is dealing with it as well. So I doubt if I'm involved there because there hasn't been any communication.
And maybe we should take it back a little and look at these email threads that were made public that go as far back as 2014. Had you seen these email threads? Had you spoken to him before about the show? Or is this the first time you're hearing about the show idea from him?
The first time I only spoke to him once, and I think it was even 2013, not 2014. He told me that he wants to do, or he wants us to do a cooking show, dinner with Somizi or something like that. But I've never seen any documents. So it came as a shock that he sent me emails, which I don't dispute, but I've never opened a document or read an email. And anyone who knows me will tell you that I'm not an email person. I started even having an email again probably 2 months ago after like 5 years of not having emails. I've got a management team that deals with anything that is to do with emails. So if he says he sent it to my personal email, I never opened it. I did have an email address, but I've never opened a document or anything like that. And that is why it's something that never stuck or was at the back of my mind when the cooking thing happened. Because when he approached me, I never even thought I would want to have a cooking show in the first place. Because I've always loved cooking, but I never thought I would take it to that level. So the cooking thing really started kicking in for me 2 years ago, I think, when social media started getting bigger and bigger. And then I decided about around February that, just after lockdown, that I'm going to have my own YouTube channel. And that is how the cooking show came about. So moving forward, it was just a natural progression of me, oh, okay, now I love cooking, now I'm ready to cook, now I can do a cooking show. And when I do a cooking show, what do I call it? Something with Somizi, whether it's dinner with Somizi, lunch with Somizi, gib-gib or popcorn with Somizi, it's me. Somizi is me, you know. So it's never been a thing that, oh, there's a document like this and there's an idea like this, let me go back to Hastings and do A, B, C, and D.
All right, Somizi, I just want to, before I let you go, just ask, I mean, briefly, just to conclude, how do you explain such a similar concept then? Is it just a concept that you had? Is it a concept that legend Manqele had, and or maybe taken from Hastings? How do you explain this sort of cooking show concept then?
For me, it's I think it baffles me because there's nothing original in the first place about my cooking show. He could have, if it was an intellectual property that is copywritten, for instance, then people like Zolanene could be sued. People like Dinner with Sipogazi could be sued. Zandin Klapo had a show 4 years ago that is exactly the same as my show. The only difference with my show, which I thought, that's why I probably thought it's an original concept, is that during brainstorming sessions, I came up with like a few ideas that I think are originally Somizi. I'll give an example, things like food for thought. There's no cooking show that has a food for thought segment where it's a motivational talk at the end of the show. And also the format of my show is slightly different to any other cooking show. Like it ends up being like a slash talk show, but also my guests. What separates my guests from any other show is that it's people that I personally know, so that it doesn't feel like an interview. It feels like a conversation, people that I have a personal experience with. And then and the title, that's what I also contributed to say. They had a different title that didn't have my name, and I said, no, I'm not going to do a show that doesn't have my name if I'm the host. So that's what baffles me. What is different from in my show that is not happening in any other cooking show?
Then it's a matter of, there is a plan to go to court. Are you going to get your lawyers involved, or is it a matter of the channel then getting their lawyers involved and going to court and battling it out with Hastings Moeng?
Like I said, in terms of the legal thing is, nothing has been said to me or sent to me. So I think it's between Hastings and Channel.
Media personality Somizi Mhlongo, thank you so much for your time. Somizi Mhlongo-Motaung was speaking to us about the intellectual property theft allegations behind the popular cooking show Dinner at Somizi's. Newsroom Africa would like to state on the record that an interview was scheduled with Hastings Moeng's attorney, Mabu Mahweshe, as we did try to reach both this morning for the scheduled engagement without any success.